Hi students, today I will be explaining you all about the IoT impact, convergence of IT and OT and challenges. Yes, we have seen these three components are also as a part of the genesis of IoT. The first component we have seen in the previous presentation, which is all about the IoT digitization. Yes, so let us recall about what is the impact. So IoT impact means, just I said, like it's a enabled process for the automation, then data collection, analytics, optimizing the work, etc., etc. Like how we all have a significant impact on managing aspects, like how we live, how we drive, how we farm, how we crop, everything. So what was the impact on all these things with respect to this IoT? Because we are going behind this IoT to automize everything. So what was the impact? How will these devices will be significant on many aspects? As I mentioned, how we live, drive, crop, farming, etc., etc. Yes? So let us move on to the next slide. Convergence, I told already, integration of IT and then OT, and followed with the challenges. Like what were the practical challenges we face when we are working behind this IoT? Let me move on to the next slide to explain you in detail about IoT impact. Yes, so IoT impact. I hope you can see the diagram. Let us discuss about the diagram after a while. I said already, like what is the significant impact of this IoT on our daily lives, like drive, crop, and then what do you say, farming, then household works, etc., etc. We are going to discuss. Yes, if you can consider the graph here. You could see number of devices connected over the internet. Yes, so this shows the number of devices which are connected and what is the growth. So the graph shows the growth in the number of devices which are being connected from 2003 to 2020. Yes or no? So these numbers means that IoT fundamentally it was shifting the way, like how the people, business will interact with the surroundings. Yes or no? This graph shows the numbers, which means to say like how the people and business were connected with the surroundings. If you can see, limited number of devices were connected from 2003 to 2010. From 2015, slowly it is started changing. And 2020, the complete population is behind the number of objects which are connected smartness, which means to say they are connected to IoT. So there is a rapid growth and the adoption rate in the business completely that we could see. Yes or no? So with the same manner, like managing, so there is a complete shift, like how the people and business interact with their surroundings, and also like managing and monitoring this smart objects or the environment, it is initiated with the real-time connectivity. Now there is no use of traffic police during the night, because almost nearby main areas everything is connected with the CCTV surveillance. So it means to say like it is easy to manage and it is easy to track the people if any issue is happened. So monitoring is become very easy through this real-time connectivity. This is one more impact with respect to this IoT on our lives. Like yes, number of systems, number of people we could optimize, and through this delivery of the services may be easier. Sorry, delivery of the services may be it is easier. So what I could say here is, when we are easy to monitor and when we are easy to connect with the system, so automatically the results we could get at a faster rate, and we expect faster services. So this is the background behind IoT impact. So this shows like what is the tremendous change in the current market, and yes, how easily we are connected to the smart system through this IoT. That is one more thing. How the automation is enabled and how the data collection is easy and how it is taking place, and how we can minimize the workflow, because we need to minimize the complete systems usage as well as number of people involvement and everything. There is a small problem, so it is getting it is coming out from the presentation mode, my system. Just give me 1 minute. Yes, so it is as easy as I mentioned. We have a significant impact on the daily lives. So let us look at this particular slide, wherein which you could see impact of IoT, where you could see with various examples. So the examples shows that it is a benefit of IoT, right, by connecting with this particular applications. First thing is connected roadways, connecting the factory, smart connecting buildings, and you can say like smart creatures, right? Yes, these are the examples. Like this, there are so many examples where this IoT connectivity was showing major impact on our daily life. So the following examples, as I mentioned, connected roadways. Now you could see in the slide, there are some intersection of the roads, and by using the sensor network with this IoT, like it will give the alarm saying that this signal is blocked, that signal is allowed, and also the speed limit, everything you could see at nearby junctions only now. Also, Google self-driving car. So now we know that it is most popular, driverless cars, and through this self-driving car, like we have come out with another revolution in the market. Yes. People are behind the self-driving car, but still the research is going on for the safety purpose. This is one more impact now. And yes, connecting the roadways, connecting the factory. There are different types of business evaluations, like integration of sensors with the newer connectivity, electronics and control. It is just like automatic control, and also the production, mass production. We were behind the number of labor, electricity, then everything, the mechanical assistance. Now you could see all the labor slowly they were replaced with the machines, robots, etc., etc. So completely this IoT is used in the industries. Also now smart connected buildings, in the sense like you could see like starting from lighting, then surveillance cameras, fixing surveillance cameras, then followed with Wi-Fi connectivity, then automatic control of the electrical appliances in the home, within the building, building management, electricity and energy management. Some of the spaces, lighting control, everything is under this IoT now, and it is getting increased day by day, right? And also smart creatures, this is the most important thing. Now almost wherever the secret missions were going on, they were using this smart creatures. So example, I have projected like RoboRat. So, it is equipped with, the rat is equipped with the complete IoT setup, like video camera, antenna, batteries, processor, receiver, electrodes which are connected to that rat brain, then sound antenna, etc., etc., they are connected. Through this, we could gain the control, or we could get the important information from the unknown people who are threatening us, also these kind of smart creators were using at the border to get the information from the these people, other country people. So like this, you could see the impact of IoT tremendously in different areas. So impact says like impact of this IoT on our daily life, like how we live, how we drive, how we form, how we construct, how we connect with a business, everything, right? So yes, so complete automation, data collection and data analytics and optimization of the work we could see with this IoT impact. Let me quickly move on to the next one, which is convergence of IT and OT and IoT challenges. Convergence of IoT and OT, IT and then OT, sorry. Yes, it's just like an integration with IT and then OT. IT means, as I told, it is used for data-centric computing, like combines both hardware and then software to treat the data, not for the applications, I said. And then OT is completely monitor the events and the complete process, devices, etc. So with this background, like OT and IT, I have given few more points here in the slide. So as IT, I said, it is required to support the operational requirements used by OT, and OT, as I mentioned, monitor the events, to monitor the events, process and devices, we should go with the network protocols, technology, transport and different types of methods of the IT organization. So these two are not reciprocal, kindly remember. IT is completely deals with the supportive operational requirements by the OT. Yes, so but when we are using this IT and then OT, there are some of the things like where it shares the protocols, it shares the networks and it shares the process. In the same manner, like some of the improvements are required for both the IT and then OT, their operating standards which are required to operate, with different types of operating standards, with different IP protocols. And also this IT, now we know it is a complete business partner with this OT, because IT is completely deals with the hardware and software combination to handle the data. So it is completely emerging with this OT now, becoming more business perspective. So OT is just like how to support and the data connectivity, both we could see. Yes, so that is what about the convergence of IT and then OT. So just how we are integrating IT with OT, right, with various networks, protocols, process, and this is all for the main purpose or main cause is just like connecting the unconnected things to the world. That was the main motto behind all these kind of components with this IoT. The last part is about the IoT challenges. Yes, I mentioned already, every network, every device is having its own challenges. In the same manner, this IoT is having its own challenges. The challenges were the feature, how it could operate, what kind of computation it takes, and etc. etc. Okay, the first challenge here is interoperability of interconnected devices. What we call as an interoperability is it's generally we say it is a feature. Yes, main parts of IoT, if you could see, they really connected but contain different types of challenges. They are really connected to the world, but different types of challenges as it is having throughout the industries and in our daily life. So with the first challenge, as I mentioned, interoperability. Interoperability means it is a feature of the system wherein which completely interfaces should completely understand, should be understand to work with other systems. It may be at present or it may be in future. So how they can operate in the present or in the future. So that is what about the interoperability, how the system is connected, how the interfaces are connected, and how well we can understood to work with the system during this present scenario or in the future. That's all. Next one is about the higher degree of smartness. So yes, higher degree of smartness, as we could see, we are running with the trending technologies. So whatever may be the automated process which we are introducing, that automated process will be it should be easily adoptable, and it should go with the autonomous power. So autonomous power means ability to perform what kind of work it should have to perform the task, what kind of power. So degree of smartness is included with the adaptation of the new trends and with the autonomous power, which deals with the ability to handle the work, and which also works with the trust, security, and then privacy. Because these three are the three components. Without the trust and without the security and without the privacy terms, we could not connect to any part of the globe. Because first we could see whether the security is there or not. Before that, we could go with whether the process is trustworthy or not. Then we could go with the security and to go with the privacy. Right. So, yeah. This is about the degree of smartness, which is one more challenge when we are working with IoT. Because of the devices and the people connected with the network. Yes, the next challenging part is things with the low resources, because IoT is equipped with the different types of sensors, actuators, then Raspberry Pi and all those things at all. So energy is the main challenging part here, and the computation power. I mentioned already, computation power is all about how much ability that it will have to perform the work. So this is a important job. So because battery life is a main problem, and the computation power, like ability, how much ability that it will takes to perform the work. That's all about the low resource. Things were at the low resource still. Due to either of the problem, like manufacturing problem or etc. But research is still going on. This is one more challenge, scalability. Yes, for every network, we cannot go easily to enhance a network because while enhancing, we need to pay an attention because every part of the network cannot be enhanced. So, developers are keep on giving the solutions to pay the attention for this enhanceability. Right. So scalability is one of the key challenge, as much as we cannot enlarge, because there are practical challenges. So all these were the IoT challenges, and as a summary, I have given scalability, security, privacy, and data analyzing, data generation and data analyzing, and the interoperability. All these five are the five challenges. Just I have given the summary at the end, that's all. So interoperability, then smartness means through the data generation, assigning the security and then privacy, then scalability, then data generation and analyzing the data, managing the data is the main important thing. So all these were the different types of challenges. Yes. So with this, I could complete the evaluation and growth of IoT, or I could say genesis of IoT part is completed. Thank you. Let us meet in the next presentation. That's all.